Hello students, let us revise what we have done in the previous two lectures. The first concept was the work was done to move a charge from point R to P and it was equal to minus integration R to P Fe dot dr. That was the work done against the field. The work required is F external. It should be equal in magnitude but opposite in direction to the electric force. This gives rise to the potential energy difference delta U, and this was Up minus Ur. And if I substitute the value of Fe, that is the Coulombian force, and do the necessary integration, it comes out to be KQ Q 1 upon RP minus 1 upon RR. This was the concept of the potential energy difference, that is potential energy difference. Second, we fixed the initial position to be infinite, that is we bring a charge from outside the field to inside the field against the field. So work done was from infinity to P. Again, this equation becomes integration infinite to P Fe dot dr, that is equal to now 1 upon infinity becomes 0. So we fixed our initial position where the potential energy is zero, and the convenient choice was outside the field or at infinity. So this gives rise to only potential energy at that point. That point is P. So this comes out to be KQQ upon RP. And this was the concept of the potential energy of charge Q. The energy will be stored in charge Q. Third, now instead of the small q charge, we bring a unit positive charge. So it was work done from R to P divided by Q. Now this Q is brought in the denominator of this, all this. So it becomes, now here Fe can be written as Q into E, that is our definition of electric field, force per unit charge. This Q is now in the denominator. So this equation becomes integration R to P E dot dr. Now say this equation, when we talk about the work done to bring a unit positive charge, it becomes E dot dr, and this gives rise to delta V, which is known as the potential difference, and this becomes Vp minus Vr. And at the same time I can relate U and V also, where delta U becomes Q times delta V also. So I can relate these two quantities. Delta V means the work done to bring 1 coulomb of charge from point R to P. So if I bring 5 coulomb, I multiply it by 5, etc. like that. So this delta V, because Q is in the denominator, if I substitute the value of electric field, that is KQ upon R square, then 1 upon R square becomes minus 1 by RI. So KQ 1 upon RP minus 1 upon RR. This is potential difference. And at the same time, we have derived this relation also, that is the relation between the potential energy difference is equal to Q times the potential difference. Potential difference is work done to bring 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to from point R to P, that is 1 coulomb or 1 unit. Now same thing, instead of R we fix a initial point infinity, so Q it becomes minus infinity to P E dot dr. This is equal to, now 1 upon RR again becomes 0, so it becomes only VP, that is equal to KQ upon RP. This is called potential at point P. Potential simply means the work done to bring a unit positive charge or work done per unit charge from infinity to a point P. Also from this, I get a relation UP is equal to Q times VP. So these are the four concepts, because we required this equation again and again in numericals as well as theory. So I have written what we have studied in lecture 1 and 2. Now let us move to a particular topics. And the first topic will be the electric potential due to point charge. Now our source will be a point charge, and you have to do the work to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to a particular point in the field against the field, against that source charge. So the next topic is potential due to the source charge or due to point charge. Now the next topic, or say our first topic, is potential due to point charge. That four definitions are the concepts. So this is the first topic where we will use that equations. Now potential due to point charge. Like the electric field due to point charge was KQ upon R square. So now you have to define potential. Potential, simply, if the potential word confuse you, you just remember it is work done to bring a unit positive charge against the field. एक कूलम्ब चार्ज को बाहर से अंदर लाने का खर्चा अगेंस्ट द फील्ड. इफ योर सोर्स इज पॉजिटिव, आवर टेस्ट चार्ज इज ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव. सो इफ आई ब्रिंग द टेस्ट चार्ज विच इज ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव, वी आर टेकिंग फॉर अवर कन्वीनियंस, एंड द सोर्स इज पॉजिटिव, यू हैव टू डू द वर्क अगेंस्ट द फील्ड. इफ द सोर्स इज नेगेटिव, देन द वर्क इज डन बाय द फील्ड. यू सिंपली प्लेस दैट टेस्ट चार्ज, the source will attract it. So there are work done by the field, work done against the field. The concepts of potential comes into picture when the work is done against the field. So now potential due to point charge. Now we will see two different methods. One method as per our NCERT book. This is more easier method, but we will be following our NCERT book. I am doing both the method. Suppose I have a source charge plus Q. This is similar to what we have done earlier, integration. Now it has a field around it. Dotted line means infinity. Dotted line means outside the field. Now potential means bahar se andar aana hai. Suppose I have to come to a point P whose position vector is R vector. The direction of the electric force, if I keep a test charge at this point P, it will move radially outward. So the direction of field or direction of force will be denoted by the unit vector R cap. Now this is one method, another we will see as per our book also. Now how to find out the potential? I have to do the work to move a unit positive charge from infinity to a point P. Bahar se andar aana hai. The first step is, how much work we have to do? The work is done by the external force, and it should be equal in magnitude and opposite to the direction of the electric force. So first thing is, find out the force acting on a unit positive charge at point P. The force acting on a unit positive charge. Now what does the force acting on a unit positive charge means? It simply means electric field. So first thing is, find out the electric field intensity. So I write force acting on unit positive charge is, now force acting on unit positive charge means F upon Q, where Q naught or test charge is taken as 1 unit or 1 coulomb. इस 1 coulomb को बाहर से अंदर लाना है. So that is electric field intensity. Electric field intensity is written as FV upon Q. That is equal to K source 1. 1 here means that is a unit positive charge. So if I write this in a word, there is no need to write this FV by Q. Directly, I will read this equation as force acting on a unit positive charge. Force acting on unit positive charge. So it is electric field. So this statement itself means it is F upon Q naught, where Q naught is taken as 1 coulomb. So remember, simply write the electric field equation. 1 for unit positive charge, R square. The direction of the electric field intensity, that is radially outward, so R cap. This is the first step. Whenever we have to find out the electric potential, find the electric field intensity at any point. This will be read as K source upon distance between the test and source. So we determine the strength. How will you do the work? We will do the work only when we know the strength of that source. So this is the strength of the source, say 5 newton per coulomb. Matlab, 1 coulomb ko bahar se andar lane ke liye 5 newton force lagana padega. This is radially outward, I have to come inward, so opposite. So first we should know the strength of the source. Strength of the source is written as force acting on unit positive charge. That is force upon Q naught. Q naught is a test charge. It is 1 unit. So I write here 1 unit, or no need to write this one. So this is the source, strength. Strength dhoond lena hai hamesha. Jabhi bhi tumhe work karna hai, you should know. If I have to lift a body, I should know what is its mass and multiply it by G, you will get the gravitational force. So minimum work it should be mg. So we found the electric field intensity. Now what was our step? Second step, the work should be done in such a way that acceleration is zero. So for that, the entire path is divided into small element. Let this element is dr vector. So instead of moving directly from outside to a point P, I move slowly and slowly, first say at point P dash, then Q dash, R dash, any point. So entire path is divided into line element. So work done to move unit positive charge for displacement dr vector is, so small amount of work done, dw. That is equal to, now when we have a unit positive charge, this equation becomes minus E dot dr. You are doing the work against the field. So work done is force into displacement. Now this is not work done. It is actually work done to move unit positive charge. This is actually Q naught is equal to 1. So work done is force into displacement. Force is Q into E. Q becomes 1 or it comes to the denominator. So this is not the work done, it is the potential. It is a potential. We read it as work done to move unit positive charge. And work done to move a unit positive charge is called potential. So this is, this much amount of work has to be done against the field. Minus sign indicate that your work should be against the field. Now this can be written as minus KQ R square R cap dot R cap dr. So unit dr can be written as unit vector into its magnitude. This becomes minus KQ upon R square dr. This is the work done to move, say, from infinity to a point P dash. Then from P dash to small division, so this is say Q dash point, so P dash to Q dash dr. So this much amount of work is done. Now my final position is P, so total work done should be obtained by integrating this equation. So integrating above equation, so dw, so total work done is equal to integration of dw. And the limit becomes infinite to point P. Now this is the work done from infinity to point P. And work done to move a unit positive charge from infinity to point P is called potential. Now this becomes integration dw minus KQ 1 upon R square dr. Infinity, position vector of point P, that is R. So limit becomes infinite to R. Again, 1 upon R square, integration is minus 1 by R. So work done from infinity to P is KQ upon R, and the limit becomes from infinity to R. That is my final position. So substituting this value, this work done from infinity to P is equal to KQ 1 upon final minus 1 upon initial. Initial was infinity. So final minus initial. This is equal to KQ upon R. And this work done is now substituted, or it can be written as potential at point P. So what is the potential at point P? So now onwards, if I say find the potential at any point, means bahar se andar aane ka kharcha against the source. So it becomes K source distance between test and source. Remember, this work done does not depend on the path followed. Even if I have moved anywhere, the distance will be from source to test only. So Vp is equal to KQ by R, and we read it, either you read it as work done to move a unit positive charge. If I write work done to move a unit positive charge, there is no need to write small q, it is, its value is 1. So potential at P is KQ by R. If Q is greater than 0, then Vp is positive. And if Q is less than 0, Vp is negative. So if the source is positive, the work done is positive, otherwise it is negative. So this is one method with the help of integration. The method is simple. First find out the intensity of the source. Whenever you have to find out the potential, try to write the equation of electric field intensity, and all the equations of electric field intensities are in chapter number 1. So first we write the intensity, do a small amount of work, integrate that small amount of work, you will get the total work, and finally you will arrive at the potential. So this is one method to find out potential due to point charge. Now let us see the method as per our textbook. Again, source is capital Q, dotted line, infinity, outside the field. We have to bring a unit positive charge at point P whose position vector is R. The direction of the field is radially outward, denoted by R cap. Now, instead of directly bringing a test charge from infinity to point P, first we bring that unit positive charge at some intermediate point, say P dash. So this is some intermediate point, not our final position. This is some intermediate point, beech ka koi rasta. This distance is R dash. See, potential and work done are scalar quantities, so I am writing the distance, R dash. If I need to write a position vector, I will put a arrow on it. So this is a distance where some intermediate position is there. P dash is some intermediate position. Now, from infinity, I have to move from infinity to point P. But first I write the electric field intensity at some intermediate position, say P dash. So, same method, first you have to always write the intensity of the source. So, force acting on unit positive charge, force acting on unit positive charge means electric field, force acting on unit positive charge at point P dash. This is some intermediate point. So that becomes K source 1. If you have to write, the distance is R dash square, and let the direction be denoted by R cap. So this is the electric field intensity. Instead of using the symbol E, we are directly writing this is the force acting on a unit positive charge at point P dash is given by. So this is our equation number 1. Now, from P dash to some intermediate point, P dash is intermediate point. Now I will divide the entire path into small elements. Suppose this point is Q dash and the distance moved is delta R dash or delta R. So this is initially we are at point P and intermediate position is P dash, and now instead of coming directly from P dash to P, I divide the entire path into small element. So it is delta R or delta R dash. So symbol you can take as per our choice. Now I will find out the work done for this. Now here the work done to move unit positive charge, the work done to move unit positive charge from R dash vector to R dash vector plus delta R dash vector. So initially I was at R dash distance, say 5 meter. I moved 1 meter inside. So the distance moved is 6 meter. So intermediate position 5 and I am coming inward. So distance will be this. So I moved from R dash to, what is the displacement inward? That is R dash plus delta R dash. Now clearly work is force into displacement. Now this is not work done. It is work done to move a unit positive charge, means work upon charge. So when we take work upon charge, it is E into displacement. It is E into displacement. Remember this. Work done is F dot R vector or F dot displacement. Now this F consists of K Q Q upon R square dot say R vector. Now this Q is taken here. So now this becomes electric field. So when I write work done to move a unit positive charge, it is an electric field intensity or work upon charge will be electric field intensity into displacement. So I am moving a small distance R dash to R dash plus delta R. So small amount of work done. Now this is electric field intensity. So KQ R dash square dot displacement. Force into displacement. Instead of force we have field, because this is not work done, this is work done to move unit positive charge. This is work upon charge. This is actually work upon charge, but its value is 1. So we are not writing it. It is potential. Now displacement. Now what is displacement? Final position minus initial. So this was our initial. O2P dash was initial. O2Q dash is final. So this final minus initial, that is OQ dash minus OP dash. So clearly it comes out to be negative. This is final position, say 4 cm. This is 5 cm. So it becomes 4 minus 5, that is minus 1. So minus sign, either you say it is work done against the field, or you say the displacement is negative. The field is radially outward, you are moving inward. So here directly minus sign, and here I write delta R dash. So this is the work done. Here negative sign appears because delta R dash is less than 0 and work done is positive. The work done comes out to be positive only. We will see that this work done to move a unit positive charge comes out to be positive. So the minus sign concept is either you say you put a minus sign that against the field, or you say the displacement is negative. You cannot take negative sign two times. So I applied this formula, work done is electric field into displacement, or you say the angle is 180. So in any case the negative sign will appear, which will also indicate that the work is done against the field. Here we have taken the final position minus the initial position. So displacement is final position minus initial. So OQ dash minus OP delta R dash comes out to be negative. This is work upon charge. Now total work done. Total work done is obtained by integrating or by doing the summation. If these elements are you are moving from towards the field, if this displacement is not very small, it does not tend to zero, I can add it also, or I can integrate also. So W is equal to, now minus integration, now our same step, you have to move from infinity to point P, that is R, KQ upon R dash square, delta R dash. So this is again the integration what we have done. So whenever we do integration, instead of delta R dash, we can write dr dash also. So that depend. Here we have taken limit delta R dash tends to 0. Limit delta R dash tends to 0. Then only we can use the integration. Otherwise, small path, you do the summation. Now again 1 upon R dash square, integration is minus 1 upon R dash. So work done is equal to K Q upon R dash, and this becomes from infinity to point P whose position vector or whose distance was R. So this work done becomes KQ 1 upon R minus 1 upon infinity. So this is work done is equal to KQ upon R. This is the work done KQ upon R. And this work done to move unit positive charge from infinity to P is called electric potential, that is our definition, that is called electric potential at point P. Therefore, potential at point P is KQ by R. So if again Q greater than 0, the work done is positive, and if Q is less than 0, Vp is negative. So work done can be work done to move a unit positive charge, or the potential can be positive or it can be negative depending upon the source. Now if you have a source as a negative charge, and if I free it here, I keep it here and free it, then it will be attracted towards the source. Then it is said that a work is done by the field. Work is done by the field. If the source is positive, then I have to do the work to move it towards the source, and that work done will be stored in the form of the potential energy or potential. Now we know electric field, the electric field due to point charge E was equal to KQ upon R square, and potential due to point charge is KQ upon R. Clearly this can be written as electric field is equal to V upon R also. So for as far as point charge is concerned, the relation can be written E is equal to V upon R. So unit of electric field is also volt per meter, that is volt per meter, or in the first chapter we have seen it is Newton per coulomb. So the as far as the point charge is concerned, the electric field is V upon R. Now let us see the graph of, here it is clear that E is inversely proportional to the square of distance, and V is inversely proportional to 1 upon R. So this is our relation, one is 1 upon R square and other is 1 upon R. So now we plot a graph . So this is dotted line is E proportional to 1 upon R square, and this solid line is V is inversely proportional to 1 upon R. So you check this graph also. So this is the plot of E or V versus R. So dotted line is for the electric field intensity, and the solid line is for the potential. So this is a potential due to point charge. Now a small MCQ based question is given in the form of illustration 1. So let us see illustration 1. Now see the direct application in the form of example 2.1. The first part is find the potential at point P due to the charge 4 into 10 is to minus 7 coulomb located at 9 centimeter away. So clearly potential means you have to bring a test charge outside the field to a point which is 9 centimeter away. So it is like plus Q, this is point P, and this distance R is equal to 9 centimeter. So source for the first part, Q is equal to 4 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb, R is 9 centimeter, that is 9 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. इसका मतलब एक कूलम को बाहर से पॉइंट पी पे लाना है, एक कूलम को लाने का खर्चा इज कॉल्ड पोटेंशियल. सो वीपी इज इक्वल टू के क्यू बाई आर, सिंपल डायरेक्ट एप्लीकेशन. सो इट बिकम्स 9 इंटू 10 रेस टू 9 इंटू 4 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 7 डिवाइडेड बाई 9 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 2. सो दिस 9 गेट कैंसल्ड. So this becomes 4 into 10 raised to 2, and this 2 comes up. So this much volt or joule per coulomb. So your the SI unit is joule per coulomb, but it is mentioned as, or it is called as volt. So what is volt? Volt, 1 volt is 1 joule per coulomb. Ek coulomb lane ka kharcha. So we will spend 4 into 10 raised to 4 joule if I have to bring 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to a point P. So this is the first part. Now see the second part. It says find out the work done to bring this much charge. अब एक कूलम लाने का खर्चा इतना, दिस इज जूल पर कूलम, इतना लाने का कितना खर्चा. सो वी टेक स्मॉल क्यू इज इक्वल टू 2 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 9 कूलम. सो इन दिस सिचुएशन पोटेंशियल इटसेल्फ मींस एक कूलम लाने का खर्चा. नाउ इंस्टेड ऑफ 1 कूलम वी ब्रॉट 2 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 9 कूलम. सो इट विल बी द वर्क डन. वर्क डन इज क्यू इनटू वीपी. So this is the work done to bring this much charge from infinity to a point P. So this will be equal to 2 into 10 raised to minus 9 into 4 into 10 raised to 4. So it becomes 8 into 10 raised to minus 5 joule has to be spent in bringing the charge Q from infinity to point P. Now it also says whether your answer depend on path. So clearly we know whatever path we follow, we get final 1 upon final position minus 1 upon initial position. So the work done does not depend on path followed. In fact, the work done depend on the initial and the final position. So this is the topic and the numerical related to potential due to point charge. Have a good day.